Good morning, everyone. This is Derek Newcomer. I am here at the Greater Providence Chamber. Yesterday, I had the tremendous privilege of working through with 14 people a workshop on the first three principles of Dr. John C. Maxwell's book, Today Matters. Today Matters is 12 daily principles to guide your daily decision making, to make sure what you're doing today is of the utmost importance, adding value to tomorrow and learning from yesterday, but maximizing what we're doing now, setting ourselves up for success. The first three principles we talked about were attitude, priorities, and health. I'd love to take the next few minutes just to run by some points that we talked about as a group yesterday. It was a great learning experience yesterday, trading ideas, trading failures, trading successes, growing as a group, great environment. So I wanted to pass on some of these points that we went over as a group. These points come straight from the John C. Maxwell curriculum, facilitator, coach, and speaker curriculum that we use to partner with businesses, to partner with individuals, and go through performance coaching, leadership coaching, prepare people to take themselves to another level. So an attitude, first point in attitude is my attitude at the beginning of a task affects its outcome more than anything else. The amount and the focus of your attitude ultimately determines how much energy you put into an activity. It comes back to you at how much you believe in yourself, how much you believe in those people around you. The amount of energy you put into that task also determines your results. Your results are going to be reflective of how much you believe in what you're doing. Are your results going to be great all the time? Absolutely not. But in the long term, your belief system will feed into your actions, will feed into your results. Your results will feed into your belief system, and it's a cycle. It's either a positive cycle that's reinforcing, or it's a negative cycle of disbelief. I don't believe I can do this, so I'm not going to put much action in. Therefore, I'm not going to really get any results. Therefore, I'm going to reinforce the belief that I couldn't do it, or I didn't. I knew that wouldn't work. The opposite is true. Massive belief, massive action, better results, reinforced belief, massive belief, massive action, etc. So it's a positive or a negative cycle. Make sure your attitude and perspective is where it needs to be to reinforce that cycle. Number two is my attitude towards others often determines their attitude towards me. Our attitude and our tone and our mannerisms can be read pretty easily, and they can be a trigger, a positive or a negative trigger, bringing out the best in those around us. Number three, my attitude, not my achievements, brings me satisfaction. Again, it's that perspective. It comes back to perspective. We're never going to succeed at everything. We're going to fail. What's our attitude as we're moving forward? And number four, my attitude is contagious. Everybody knows the person who walks into a room and instantly deflates the energy in the room. Everybody knows a person who walks in the room and instantly raises the energy in the room. You want to be around those people. Attitude is contagious. What are you spreading? That's the big question. What are you spreading? So number two, point number two that we went through yesterday were priorities. How are your choices reflecting what's most important? Yesterday I shared my hierarchy of decision making, my priorities, faith, family, personal growth. Those are my three decision making priorities. My choices are bounced off of that hierarchy of priorities. And based on that hierarchy of priorities, I make my decisions and I feed my purpose, what I'm created to do. Points to think about as you think about your priorities and where your time is going. Time is our most precious commodity. It can be neither rewound, it can't be fast forward, it can't be stopped. You can't get it back, so where is it going? Number two is we cannot change time, only our priorities. We can only change and only change the decisions on where we put our time. So what are your decisions reflecting? Number three is priorities help us choose wisely. What is most important? Having that hierarchy of decision making gives us a chart, or it gives us a checks and balance system on how to choose. What is most important? Where is my time going? Where is the utmost value going? Three questions to help you prioritize. Three questions to ask to help you prioritize your choices and your time. What is required of me? When you go on the job, what is required of you? When you go home, what is required of you? When I go home, I can't check out. I gotta switch gears. I have a loving wife. I have three little boys, 7, 5, and 3. Can't check out. It's time to switch gears and add value to my family. Add value to my wife. Add value to my three little boys. What gives me the greatest return? It's going back to that Pareto principle, the 80-20 rule, especially when it comes on to on the job, growing a business. What gives me the greatest return on my energies? What can I do that gives me the greatest return? And what can I teach somebody else to do or pass along to somebody else so they can do the support work, so they can help in the system? Where's my time of most value and will give me the greatest return? And the last one is, what gives me the greatest reward? What speaks into your legacy? What speaks into the long term? What gives you the greatest reward, that internal satisfaction? And the last four points are your daily priorities. What tasks or what do you have to do on a daily basis to make sure you're feeding what is most important, to make sure you're feeding your passions, to make sure you're feeding your lifestyle, what you're growing for? My four, and these aren't your four, you have to make your own four. My four are develop relationships is the first one. Lead and encourage is the second one. I have to develop relationships in what I do. Everybody has to. We are created to feed off each other and grow together. If you're at the top of the mountain and there's nobody with you, then you did something wrong. You have to grow those around you. Number two is lead and encourage. Set the example, encourage those around you. Number three is challenge. I love to challenge myself, and I love to challenge those people around me. Push them outside of my comfort zone. And the last one is teach and communicate. I love doing workshops, facilitating groups, challenging each other, growing together. It's that teach and communicate portion. So what are your priorities? What is your hierarchy of checks and balances on where your time is going? And what are you doing with your time? Last point we went over yesterday was health. Some of you know me, some of you don't. I'm a fitness professional. I have 11 years in the industry. I own my own small personal training business. I believe health plays a vital role in our overall success. Whether it's energy level, whether it's clarity of mind, whether it's the ability to perform at our top of our game for the entire day, having the energy inside us to do that. Our nutrition, our exercise is gonna either add value to what we're doing or it's gonna take away. And it's a lot easier to maintain your health than to try to regain it later in life. So are your healthy or unhealthy habits adding value or taking away value of what you can give to your responsibilities, to your family, to your faith, to your business, to your friends, to your activities? Is your health supporting that system? This is Derek Newcomer. Thank you for taking time watching this video. Take these three points, internalize them, take a nugget or two, and apply it. Coming again from the Greater Providence Chamber, it's been a privilege to work with this group yesterday. I look forward to doing more workshops here in the future. Again, Derek Newcomer, make a great rest of your day.